My earlier stories are not of Cochin. One of the reasons is that I thought city is an important part of writing. I was inspired in my childhood by James Joyce, Borges, all wrote about cities of their birth. So that was a preconceived notion. So I was looking into the urban situation quite a lot. But the book I wrote about Kochi was my novel, which traces from 1951 to 1967, and even from beyond. It's called Lanthan Batheriyile Luthiniyakal. It's translated in English as Litanies of Dutch Battery and published by Penguin. It traces the, it's actually how a child is born in 1951, a girl child, and how she grows in one of the islands. Well, not on this side is all well taken off, Mattancheri, Fort Kochi, these are all well populated, well connected islands. There are hundreds of islands on the other side which were isolated at that time, till about 15 years back when all the bridges came. So growing up in that island, the utter isolation, it's an imaginary island, but it's actually, it is located somewhere near Bolgati. Because, which can be made up, because one of the greatest cultural institution of that period was a toddy shop in Bolgati. So all the Malayalam writers used to take a boat, go there, drink. This Changambula used to walk all the way from Kadapalli. So that was quite a cultural institution. But I gave the name of an imaginary island because, as I said, it's very difficult to write the history of Kochi because so many of facts and fables. So safer and better option was fiction, though there are many areas in which, say, which are backed historically, but some of it is pure fiction. The Jewish story in Kochi, I mean, there's so many fables. There's nothing on record till the Raja gives his that copper plate. Before that, you don't have. And if you ask the white Jews there, so they'll trace it back to 70 BC or something. It may be true, but it's all tradition. So through that, so two major ideas that came during that period was the arrival of communism in Kerala and the influence of church also growing. So that was the major political background of that period, which I tried to capture all through the eyes of, in first person, through the eyes of this girl. There's a lot of, the period of the novel is from 1951 to, but as Kochi people do, when people start talking, they will go back. So through conversation, taking it back to a lot of time. There are many unsubstantiated stories I have put in it, like the visit of Amrita Shergill. So Amrita Shergill, it is said by Cochinites that Amrita Shergill has come to Kochi and she stayed in Mattancheri and she copied all the murals of the Mattancheri palace and that has influenced her. And the four main paintings, Brahmacharin's Bride's Toilet, were probably the outlines were drawn in Kochi. I've gone through all the documents, all the available books on. Yes, she was in Kochi during 1936. After Kochi, she had gone to Cape Comorin, where she meets Gandhi. But this is a part, this story, I've started hearing it, I don't know from where. From the time I was a child, because my father, when he used to take me to Mattancheri, he said this famous painter used to stay here. So that kind of you get a lot of stories like the ships of Cochin. You know, there are many ships, which is true because the first written account of Kochi was published somewhere in 1751 by Ma Huan, who came with the famous Chinese admiral Sheng He. So he mentions about a lot of shipbuilding yards in Kochi and a lot of ships being built and lots of ships on the water. And there's a lot of story. Then, as a part of my interest in this matter, when I went to the Royal Maritime Museum in Greenwich, I started looking for what they call CR, Cochin Registered Ships. I could only find out one or two records. Whereas this must have been a great place for shipbuilding because of the teak. All these are there, but we did not have the sense of history probably. The mapping of Kochi came much later. There is even a mention about last one of the viceroys traveling by a Cochin ship, but it's not substantiated by anything on the documents. But there were five big shipbuilding yards in Kochi. One is where that Nehru Park opposite Brandon Park and Kochanadi and five places. Brandon's Boatyard, which is not the hotel. The hotel has taken the name from another place, which is somewhere near Edakochi. So they were all there, but I don't think even a maritime museum is here. Nothing much has been documented about them.